Hello, Panthers. Today we will discuss communication across cultures. This lecture ties to the rhetorical analysis and understanding of your audience lecture we shared a few weeks ago. As stated in the article from the American Society of Mechanical Engineers website, worldwide business organizations have discovered that intercultural communication is a subject of importance, not just because of increased globalization, but also because their domestic workforce is growing more and more diverse ethnically and culturally. So what is culture? Culture consists of beliefs, attitudes, behaviors, values, and assumptions shared by a group of people. It is a conscious and unconscious learning process which over time turns into beliefs and values that shape our daily lives and actions. Culture is dynamic and complex. It is fluid and tends to evolve with time. To understand the depths of its dynamic properties, it is important to pay attention to the cultural context of communication. Culture is a part of the very fabric of our thought. We cannot separate ourselves from culture. In the same way, every business or organization has a culture of its own. When communicating across cultures, in order to get a better understanding of your audience, check the following factors. Do you know your audience credentials? What level of education or degree have they earned? Check their professional experience. This information will help you understand your audience's expertise and the appropriate level and style at which you should address this audience. Next, check job responsibilities and analyze what type of information and format would be the most effective for this type of audience. Check personal characteristics and preferences. Some audience might prefer formal communication while others might not care. Look for personal preferences to see if your audience leans more towards textual explanation or graphics. If your reader is fine with first-person pronouns or not. Consider the cultural characteristics. They will help you understand the most effective approach to communicate your information. For example, if your audience is from an Asian culture, they focus more on a whole rather than a part. Or in other words, they focus on relationships between organizations more than on individuals. The document written to these audience should use plural pronouns rather than singular pronouns, so use we rather than I. Asian cultures have a little divide between work and home. Communication addressed to these audiences should inquire about their family, health, and weather, etc. When addressing Asian audience, use formal tone, style, and format. These cultural checks and approaches seem unimportant, but they really help make communication more effective and dynamic.